All right. Lawmakers on both sides of the aisle are going after the president's actions on health care. Ending subsidy payments, there's an argument to be made that he is hurting the most vulnerable Americans. Signing this executive order that allows, allows for these cost-sharing subsidies to no longer be paid. Is that really damaging or is it helping? Let's discuss. We have CNN contributor Dr. Zeke Emanuel, one of the architects of Obamacare, and CNN senior political commentator Rick Santorum, who helped craft the Republican Graham-Cassidy bill. It's good to have you both with us for this. Rick, I know you were caught in traffic. Thank you for beating the conditions and getting to us. The president's executive action on cost-sharing revenues, cutting them. The right move, why?
Well, I think it was the right move because it actually puts a gun to the Congress's head to try to do something to try to fix the broken system that is Obamacare today. If the Democrats knew that they were going to continue to get the milk, they didn't have to buy the cow. They were going to continue to get these subsidies, even though they're illegal. I mean, it's very clear. The courts made it very clear that unless Congress appropriates this money, the president can't spend it. President Obama did. President Trump did. But President Trump finally said, no, I'm not going to do this anymore. The courts have been very clear. I can't spend money that Congress doesn't appropriate. So he's now put it back to the Congress, say, you want to appropriate this money? Fine, but we need to reduce premiums. And that's what Republicans are saying. You talk about those who are vulnerable because they've lost these cost-sharing reductions. How about the millions of Americans who are not getting any help from the federal government on these exchanges and are going out there and buying policies that are, you know, double what they were just a few years ago? Those are the folks who are getting hurt, and that's what Republicans are looking at, trying to help them.
Let's go point by point, but Zeke, for the purpose of discussion, let's leave the legality of the payments out. It wasn't decided yet. It was one district court that did it. The appeal may now have been rendered moot by this action by the president because you don't have an underlying grievance to be held in that litigation. So let's put that to the side, and let's talk about Rick's two main premises. One, that the president did the right thing because he had to force the hand of Congress, and two, that this isn't really hurting anybody. It's helping premiums.
So let's make three points. The first point is we need to see the revoking of these cost-sharing subsidies in a long sequence in which the president is trying to undermine health insurance. He shortened the open enrollment period. He's reduced the advertising to get people to buy plans. He's trying to siphon off healthy people into these so-called association plans, and now he's eliminating the cost-sharing subsidies. Former Senator Santorum is right that there's a group of people who've seen their premiums go up who aren't getting subsidies. They make about $100,000 or more per household, and a small fraction of them, the healthy and the young in that category, will in fact get cheaper premiums. But everyone else, everyone in the exchanges and people who are buying who happen to be middle-aged or have some pre-existing condition will not get a benefit. And those people are going to see their premiums go up at least 20%. On average, many more people will see their premiums go up. Let me tell you about a guy I met the other day, a cameraman, who actually was born with a defect in his heart and has had three cardiac surgeries. He is going to be totally priced out of the market because of the president's actions. He's going to see his premiums skyrocket. So the idea that this is helping and making premiums more affordable, totally untrue. And it's certainly untrue for all of us who get our premiums from our employer. This is just fake news that this is going to make premiums better. There will be a few hundred thousand people who will benefit. Most people will not benefit.
Rick. I would say this. First off, the act of itself of not funding these CSRs, I agree with you. It's not going to make premiums lower. But the point is,
all right, so we've just unmasked the president's justification.
No.
Justification.
No, it's not a false justification, Zeke. What the president's doing is saying, number one, it's illegal. Number two, Congress, you have to act to lower premiums. He's done some things that will lower premiums, but the Congress needs to do more. And that's the point that, you know, Ron Johnson and Mark Meadows and a group of Republicans are going to put something on the table this week that's going to lower premiums in exchange for conservatives voting for these cost-sharing reduction payments. If the Democrats are serious about trying to lower premiums for the gentleman you just talked about,
they need to do that. For a Republican proposal to have a lower premiums. There's not been one Republican proposal to lower premiums that has been scored by an independent group, whether the Congressional Budget Office, Standard & Poor's, or any number of other groups that evaluate these things, that has said They have a proposal that'll lower premiums. We will wait to see it, but we have a proposal. I've given the president many ideas about lowering premiums. Go after drugs, which there's bipartisan support for. He hasn't done that, has never submitted legislation. Change how we pay doctors and hospitals. Probably the best way of lowering premiums. They've actually reversed that in HHS under former Secretary of Secretary Price. Change how we actually buy hospital beds or CPAP machines or other things.
So, Zeke, what you're talking about is everything but what Republicans believe is it will lower premiums, which is competition, which is choice, which is giving consumers different choices that right now they don't have because Obamacare forces you to buy a lot of things that you don't want to have to pay for and drives up the cost accordingly.
All right,
what we need to do is give consumers choices.
So
that's what Donald Trump is trying to do.
Wait a second.
Strong point, Rick, but deal with his point.
In 2018, there was not a single county, there was projected not to be a single county without health insurance. Now, as a result of his executive action and these cost-sharing subsidies, there will be many counties without a insurance
plan.
That is not competition. That is anti-competition. He has, in fact, undermined competition.
You can't blame Donald
market.
Trump for the failure of Obamacare. This thing has been in a death spiral for a few years. You never met the numbers that the Congressional Budget Office.
All right, so wait. Let's take that proposition, Rick. Let's take that proposition, Zeke. This is a big point. We hear it all the time. Obamacare is in a death spiral. It's missing its numbers. It's dying.
False. So first of all, independent evaluations by Standard & Poor's, who doesn't have a dog in the political fight, by the Congressional Budget Office and many other groups have said that the exchanges are here to stay. They're solid. They're going to go. Now, you are going to have some problems in certain places, especially rural areas, where it's hard to put together a big network and there aren't many consumers. That is not a death spiral. And well-run exchanges like the Cover California actually are doing well because they have answered all the problems Mr. Santorum has said. They have more competition. They've had larger areas. They've actually done a lot of advertising to bring people in. If you want to actually get premiums down, keep the exchanges healthy, what you do is you pass the cost-sharing subsidies. You have reinsurance in case excess sick people come in. You heavily advertise. You increase the length of open enrollment, and you target young and healthy people to encourage them to get insurance and indicate to them how cheap the insurance is for them with subsidies. Those will shore up the exchanges. Those will bring in insurance companies, and that will keep the prices of the premiums down.
All of those things are being done.
They don't have an idea how
to lower premiums.
All of those things are being done by President Obama prior to President Trump coming in place, and what happened? What happened is, you cite CBO. CBO is off by over 50% as far as the number of people insured here. The bottom line is most of the gains of insured have not been through the exchanges. As you know, Zeke, it's been adding to the Medicaid rolls, which is expanding government insurance. The bottom line is your private sector reforms failed miserably. The costs are high unless you get subsidies. You're driving people out of the marketplace right now. It is a disaster, and Donald Trump is trying to fix it. Give him credit for at least trying.
All right, gentlemen.
No, because his policies are actually undermining the exchange, and he's not going to lower premiums.
All right,
I would like us to come back and see if for the 2018 premiums go down or they go up 20%.
Done.
If they go up 20%, Rick Santorum has to eat his words.
Done.
Fine.
Done. I don't know about the eat the words part. We'll see what happens, but I'll tell you this much. This is a good pairing. We'll do this several more times. Fellas, okay. Thank you very much. Appreciate it. All right, what do you say?